हेलो एवरीवन, टॉपिक ऑफ माय पेपर इज रोल ऑफ मल्टी डायरेक्टर कंप्यूटर टोमोग्राफी इन इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ ब्लंट एब्डोमिनल ट्रॉमा। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर अक्षत भारद्वाज अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ डॉक्टर नेहा बागड़ी फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वीडियो डायग्नोसिस, वर्धमान महावीर मेडिकल कॉलेज उज्जैन हॉस्पिटल न्यू दिल्ली। नाउ ब्लंट एब्डोमिनल ट्रॉमा इज अ वेरी लीडिंग कॉज ऑफ मॉर्बिडिटी एंड मोर्टैलिटी इन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज एंड इज द मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज ऑफ डेथ अंडर 45 ईयर्स ऑफ एज। T-series technique of choice for initial examination after blunt trauma, as it is highly sensitive, specific, and accurate for use in detecting the injury and extent in minimum time and increased resolution. The speed and accuracy of multi-detector CT in detecting multi-organ injury leads to prompt diagnosis and triage of patients, thus reducing scanning time, motion artifacts, and increasing image resolution. Now, aim and objectives: to illustrate a spectrum of imaging findings in patients presenting blunt abdominal trauma, to detect the role of CCT abdomen evaluation of patients of blunt trauma. The methods: patient admitted to emergency department with history and or presentation of blunt abdominal trauma, which were hemodynamic stable, underwent CCT abdomen with Siemens 256 light scanner. Patient who were hemodynamically unstable with history of contrast, allergy, and deranged KFT were excluded from study. The scanning extent was from domes of diaphragm till pubic symphysis. Non-contrast scan was followed by post-contrast RTL and venous phase. Contrast was given 100 to 120 ml of non-ionic intravenous at 3.5 to 5 ml per second using pressure injector. Case 1. A 45-year-old male presented with history of trauma and was fast positive. Now, axial scans of CCT abdomen in the portovenous phase shows an ill-defined non-enhancing confluent and linear region seen in segment 6 of liver reaching up to the subcapsular area and is seen to be communicative with the fluid density in the hepatorenal space, suggestive of liver contusion and laceration. No vascular injury was seen. This came out to be asked liver injury grade 3. Now, as you can see, there's a non-enhancing lesion in the well-defined lesion in the left atrium, which was well-defined and was hyperdense or non-contrast as well. This came out to be and showed no post-contrast enhancement. This was suggestive of bilateral adrenal hematoma in the same patient. A 40-year-old male presented with history of trauma and fast positive. Again, you can see the ill-defined non-enhancing confluent linear region seen in the liver in bilateral lobes, reaching up to the subcapsular area, suggestive liver contusion and laceration. The parenchymal depth was more than 3 cm and it was 3 Cunard segment. No vascular injury was seen. This was asked grade 4. Now, on a 26-year-old male with history of trauma fall from height, axial CCT shows, RTL portovenous shows ill-defined non-enhancing confluent linear regions more than 3 cm, seen involving mid and lower pole and involving the segmental vessels with more than 25% involvement of splenic parenchyma. This came out to be asked the splenic injury grade 4. Now, in this, you can see in the CCT abdomen phase, in the RTL and the portovenous phase shows a non-enhancing linear region, 1.1 cm in depth, seen in interpolar region, reaching up to the pelvic laser system, but not involving it. On the delayed scan, there is no extravasation of contrast or involvement of the pelvis. Large fluid collection was seen around the right kidney. No active extravasation of contrast was seen. This was asked kidney injury grade 2. Now, our results was, more 80% of the patients who were presented in the trauma setting were male, 6% of female. So the most common mode of injury was road traffic accident, which included 7% of all the patients. Now, in distribution of patients, maximum patients belonged to 20 to 40 years, which was in the working class of the patients who were in working class, which came out to be 21. Now, when we quantified hemoperitoneum, maximum number of patients presented with moderate hemoperitoneum. When we distributed according to the intra-abdominal injuries, 25 of them presented with soil organ injuries, 6 presented with bowel mesenteric injuries, and 2 presented with bladder injuries. Now, if we distribution of severity of soil organ injuries, we can see that the most common organ involved was spleen. After that, there was liver. In liver, the most common injury was ask grade 4, which was included, which was 50% of all the patients, and ask grade 3. In spleen, the most common was ask grade 3, then 4, and renal ask 3. Now, in the discussion, most of the patients presenting with trauma were males and were between 20 to 40 years of age. Most patients presented with moderate hemoperitoneum. Spleen was the most common soil organ injury followed by liver. Now, the limitation of the study was that this was a descriptive and cross-section study with no operative follow-up of patients. Study had a relatively small sample size in a small time period. Only 30 patients were taken up for this study. Now, finally, discussion and conclusion. CT is a very good imaging modality to identify hematoma, contusion, and laceration. It helps in grading of the type of injury and deciding the management of patients. High quality of image data that can be further processed into MPM, multi-layer deformated for maximum intensity projection and three-dimensional volumetric images often aid in the diagnosis of complex injuries in the trauma patient. Now, MDCT is very highly available, provides a better resolution, better sensitivity and specificity of organ injuries in patient blunt abdominal trauma with limited scanning time and can be used in emergency purposes. Thus, it is an important tool in making a decision between operative versus conservative management and helps in prognostication of. Now, these are my references. Thank you very much.